It's time to beat the clock. Lights of Broadway, sights of Broadway, sounds of Broadway all around. And there above shines the Pennsylvania, pioneering light, sight, and sound. Finer products, better products, best in quality. Made for you by Pennsylvania, pioneer for half a century. Beat the clock from Pennsylvania, beat the clock. To entertain ya, it's time to play Beat the Clock.
And now here he is, back from his vacation, America's number one clock watcher, Bud Collyer!
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Welcome once again to Beat the Clock, a show where you can have the time of your life playing against time for big time prizes. And thank you for your welcome, Vern Bennett. And now, if you come over here with me, let's welcome again. I'll have to meet our really brand new contestants to me, our holdovers from last week. Private and Mrs. Edward Sankovich, is that right? How are you, Mrs. Sankovich? Yeah. Welcome back. And how are you, sir?
Fine.
I guess you had a chance to meet my good friend John Reed King last week, didn't you? Well, I want to publicly right now thank you, Johnny, and tell you just exactly all the wonderful reports I had while I was away. In a way, I'm glad I came back because they were two good reports. But in any event, it's wonderful to have a guy that will step in and pinch hit for you so that you can get away and take a little rest once in a while, isn't it?
Swell.
And now, what are you folks doing up here?
Just the show.
Just the show. You live in Fairlawn, New Jersey.
That's right.
And how long have you been in the Army, Ed?
7.5 months.
Are you going to make a career of it, or when you get through, are you going to get back in civilian life?
Undecided.
You're undecided now, so what are you going to do? And you've been married 1 year, is that right? Okay, now let's see. Had you beaten the $100 clock you had when time ran out last time? So your problem now is on the $200 clock, and you hadn't even started it, had you? Well, we'll find out what it is. All right, now, our problem on the $200 clock involves only your husband, Mrs. Sankovich. You can just stand right here and be a cheering section for him. Ed, you come over here with me, will you please? Now, I want you to stand alongside of me. I want to show you here that we have 7 boxes in a row here, you see? And at the end of the entire row, you'll notice we have, like, goalposts set up. Now, you can call this soccer if you want to. We're going to play a little game of soccer. And if you'll walk along here with me, I'll show you what it is you have to do. You have to, like you would in soccer, of course, not using your hands at any time, but only with your feet, always remaining playing the game from this side of this row of boxes, remove this first box from the row, and kick it through there for a goal. Come back here, get the second box, move it from the line, kick it through for a goal, and so on right down the line until you made 7 goals, one with each of those boxes, which we're using instead of soccer balls. You understand? It's comparatively simple, and if you come on back here now, you may have wondered just a little bit why these extra boxes. Well, you never know when you're going to need extra boxes. Meantime, let's take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have. 50 seconds to get every one of those boxes, starting from the first one and working in order, through there for 7 goals. Now, these are your soccer shoes. Will you step in them, please? You must do the entire thing with your feet in those boxes at all times. You understand, Ed? I haven't got much time. It's 50 seconds, so don't move slow. You ready, boy? But for the same token, don't fall. Go. That's one. Come on, boy. That's two. Come on. That's three. Come on, get this one. That's four. Come on. Ed, do you think your basic training in the Army had anything to do with the condition you had to be in for that? Didn't hurt any, did it, huh? Well, you did fine. And that means, of course, you've beaten the $200 clock, and now we come to the point where the wife takes over. This is entirely your problem, our jackpot clock, Miss Sankovich. So, Ed, you've just got to stand by over there, catch your breath. You can't help your wife in any way. Just hold good thoughts for her all the time, will you? Miss Sankovich, will you just stand right down there? I'll tell you when you get up on the platform. Now, on back of this curtain, as you probably know, is our famous jackpot board, our magnetic board. It holds all of the words of a famous saying or quotation. They're all scrambled around out of order. Now, you have exactly 20 seconds from the time I say go to unscramble those words and put them out in the proper order so they spell out, reading from left to right, the famous saying or quotation we're after. Do you understand the problem? Okay. Pull back the curtain. Step up on the platform. Go. No, there's something wrong. Look at it, quickly. There's something, two words in the wrong place. You can't help her, Ed. You can't eat your cake and have it too, but what? Quick. Come on, time's running out. Two words are wrong. Oh, golly, you didn't quite make it, Mrs. Sinkovich. It's you can't have your cake and eat it too, is what it amounts to. I'm awful sorry, just one word was out of the way there, but you've done mighty well. Ed, come on back in here because you have still beaten our jackpot clock. So let's see what, not a jackpot, but our $200 clock, let's see what you've won.
A beautiful half sofa from the Shaw Manufacturing Company of Charlotte, North Carolina. Two versatile pieces scaled to average room size with hair-filled construction for luxurious comfort, exemplifying the very best in Shaw craftsmanship. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Sankovich. You have just won a Beat the Clock prize worth more than $200.
Hi, congratulations.
Contestant. We have Mr. and Mrs. John Pavlin from Birmingham, Alabama.
Thank you very much, Roxanne. Hello, Miss Pavlin. How are you? Pavlin, that's almost like the baby food, isn't it? John, how are you, sir? Nice to have you both with us. You know, I forgot to explain to our first contestants. I should have explained it to them, but fortunately the bell didn't ring, or maybe unfortunately, as the case may be. Our bonus. I was quite amazed when I got back from my vacation to find it still going on. Thought somebody would have gotten it by now. But in any event, whenever the bell rings during the show, and had it rung during our first contestants, I would have explained it then. It's worth $500 tonight, and whenever that bell rings, that's the person who gets a try at the bonus. Maybe you, maybe anybody on the show. We don't know till that bell rings. Even I don't know. John, what do you do in Birmingham?
I'm a supervisor, sales supervisor.
For what?
National Industrial Laundries.
But you might as well get that plug in, you know, boy. You go back there and tell them about it. Maybe you get a raise. What about children?
No children.
I see. This vacation trip for you?
That's right.
Well, good. I hope you're enjoying yourselves.
Business, too.
Good. Okay. She gets the pleasure and you get the business. All right. We have a little problem that should be very restful for you. I don't think you'll have any trouble with it at all. As a matter of fact, you've probably seen these little items many times and wondered how they were used, or maybe you knew. But for the $100 clock, will you both come over here with me, please?
Well, thank you, Betty. Thank you very much. My goodness.
This is one of those little seat cane sticks, whatever you call them, you know? We've taped it so it won't collapse on you in any way. What they do is fold up. You can put them in a golf bag, carry them with you when you're going to a football game. There aren't any seats. You can just kind of sit this thing down and sit on it. You've probably seen them, haven't you? Or seen pictures of them? They're really comparatively comfortable. Now, that's all we want you to do is, with your combined efforts, wind up with your husband sitting on this little cane, just the way I was there. With these two things out the side, you just perch on it like that, and he'd be very comfortable. See? I'll put it down here on the ground. Take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have. 45 seconds from the time I say go. You may not touch it at any time with your hands, nor may you take it in your teeth. Only thing you can use is your feet and your legs in some way like that. But you cannot touch it with your hands or your arms, nor bite it with your mouth. You understand the problem? You can help each other, though. Both of you can work at it, but you must wind up sitting on it. Are you ready? Go. He's got to sit on it, not you. He's got to sit on it. Get away from it. Got to get away from it. See if he's on it. He's got to wind up on it. No, you're pushing it back this way. Get your hand away. Get your hands away. No, he's not on it. Push it over that way more. A little more. Are you sitting on it? You sitting good and solid? All right, stop the clock. I don't advise you to try that. If you need one of those in a hurry, don't put it up that way. You'll find there are lots easier ways of doing it. All right. Now, of course, that means you go into the $100 clock. You move up to the $200 clock. And, of course, by easy stages, we work our way up. Maybe you'll get a try at that jackpot clock. Good luck to you. We hope you do. How long do you expect to be up here in town, Mr. Pavlin?
A day or two.
Just a day or two. You won't be here then to help us. We're going to welcome, a little ahead of anybody else, the American Legion is coming in town for their convention, you know. I don't know if we have any of you fellas in the house here tonight, but if we have, welcome to you. We hope you enjoy your stay with us. We'll try to make it as pleasant as possible. Okay, somebody started a hand for the Legion. Go ahead and give it to them. They deserve it. All right, we'll find what your problem is and just... All right now, Miss Pavlin, look what we did to your husband. We got him all fixed up. You know why? Come on in, John. Stand alongside your wife there. The reason we got you fixed up like, do you ever bowl? Miss Pavlin, do you ever do any bowling?
Some.
You like it?
Yes, I
Well, we have a bowling alley night. We needed a guy to act as pin boy, so that's what John is going to do. He's going to be your pin boy while you do some bowling. If you'll come over here, I'll show you our portable bowling alley. And we bring out our bowling alley, please. There we are. A pretty girl. My goodness. Now, John, if you'll step around back there to be the pin boy, Madeline will get you fixed up while I'm showing Mrs. Pavlin what it is she has to do. What we're going to do, Miss Pavlin, you see down at the end, we're going to seat your husband down there so he can put the pins up, you see? And they're the pins. They're three little paper cups. We're going to set three sets of those up there. We want you to make a strike by knocking them all off there as best you can. Do you understand? You'll roll one bowling ball, theoretically, and you'll knock off three. Then we'll give you a fresh one, and he'll set up three more, and then so forth. Now, John, you really got a pinch hit in here, you know. You've really got... There are your supply of pins. See them over there? Now, you see about... See the marks where these three are? They're marked right there. And as soon as she knocks all those off, you get three more and set them right up there again. Then you just watch real close and see what she does with them. You understand? It's very simple. Let's take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have. 35 seconds from the time I say go. Would you bring up the bowling balls, please? These are whipped cream, you see? And you shake them good and hard like that. And then if you just simply point this little tip down like that, interesting things happen. And you knock all of those off, we'll give you a fresh one, set them up, get them all down, three strikes, we'll stop the clock, you'll beat the clock. You understand your problem? Are you ready? Boy, does she look eager. Go! Get another one off. Get those two off there. Come on, here you are. Shake it up good. Shake it. Lean right down there. Hey, that's it. One more. Okay, knock him down. Come on, give her a fresh one. There you are. That's it. Knock him down. Knock him down. Lean right in there. Lean right down. Lean right in there. That's it. Oh, wait a minute. Hold it. Hold it. Got to clean the bowling alley off here. We're stuck. Drop those off. Put three more up because those were stuck. Here, let me just take this and clean the alley a little bit. That's the idea. Clean the alley. There we are. Okay, now set... Set three more. He says it tastes good. All right, set three more up. Go ahead. All right, you set them up for him this time. That's it. Get these off and we'll count it. Go. Now, come on, there's two. One to go. Here, come on. Get a good roll there. Come on. Knock it right down there. Tell you what, step right down the side. Sneak right down the alley. That's the idea. All right, stop the clock. Super flash, flash ball. Blue dot for sure shot. You want to wipe your hands? Well, give her a towel. Let her wipe the whipped cream off her hands, and we'll take her back because she's got work to do. Come on, you take that right back with you. Mrs. Pavlin. Well, we did a good job on him, I think, don't you? That's the kind of bowling that husbands and wives should enjoy, I think. Now, if you just drop that towel anywhere there, that's the idea. Step right down there because now you've got to try our jackpot clock. Remember, as the lady before you, in back of this curtain is our famous jackpot board, and the words of a famous saying or quotation are there, but they're all out of order. You can move them around on the board, and that's what I want you to do. Move them around so that they spell out in 20 seconds from the time I say go, the saying or quotation we're after. Do you understand? Okay. Pull back the curtain. Go. Look at it now. Look at it. Look at it. See if you can figure out the saying. Famous. Oh, I'm sorry, but here there's us nobody chickens. No, what it is there's nobody here but us chickens. That's what it is. Nobody here but us chickens. I'm sorry you didn't beat the jackpot clock, but you two have beaten the $200 clock, so while your husband's getting cleaned up, let's just see what you've won.
From the Speed Queen Corporation of Ripon, Wisconsin, a Speed Queen automatic clothes dryer. With a safe overhead radiant heat unit, which eliminates clothes scorching dangers, kills germs, and safeguards your family's health. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Pavlin. You've just won a beat-the-clock prize worth more than $200.
Thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Mrs. John Jakes from Greencastle, Indiana.
Mr. and Mrs. John Jakes, is that right?
That's right.
J-A-K-E-S, Greencastle, Indiana. What's that near, John?
35 miles west of Indianapolis.
Ah, now we got it pegged. What do you do?
Well, part-time I go to school, but most of the time I write. I've been writing for the last couple of years.
Well, good boy. And what sort of writing do you do?
Well, pulp magazine, science fiction mainly, and western stories.
God, how'd you happen to get interested in that sort of thing?
Well, I don't read it.
I don't mean writing. I mean, theoretically, people get a bent one way or the other, but I meant writing that particular kind of literature.
Well, I started when I was little. And it read paid, the stuff.
And it began to pay off, so
yeah.
You stuck with it.
I kept at it.
How long have you been married, Mrs. Jakes?
A year and a month.
A year and a month. The anniversary was a month ago.
That's
I'm
right.
Sorry I wasn't here to wish you many happy returns, but I'll do that right now.
Thank you, sir.
Many happy returns to you. Okay, well, now we'll see what we have on the line for you. Incidentally, I might could use you right now, as a matter of fact, to write a little plug for me, you know, a little squib or whatever they call it in writing parlance, because we have a little special welcome tonight to some folks out in Rock Island, Illinois. Normally, they've been receiving our show on Kinescope or one means or another, not at the same time as we're getting it here in New York on the network. Tonight, they joined the live network. So, Rock Island, Illinois, welcome. We're awful glad to have you here at the same time as all the rest of us. Now, let's see. Your problem is going to be one for your wife. She's going to have to work for this one. Yeah. You stand over here and write the copy. Hold her gloves for her, if you will. It's kind of athletic here. So you come over here with me, if you will, Ms. Jakes, and I'll show you what it is you have to do. Now, you notice this line on the stage? That's your area of operation. You must remain behind that at all times. And we have taken here a little beach ball, and we've fastened it up by elastic. Look at that thing bounce. Isn't that wonderful? Now, what you have to do is to take this beach ball, and it'll come back to you, of course, as it swings back each time, throw it at each one of those little schmooze that we have standing in those little platforms. One at a time, knock them all off, we'll stop the clock, and you'll beat the clock. Now, don't step over that line, understand?
Okay.
Just knock each one of those schmooze off in how many seconds? Take a look over your shoulder. Sylvania says 40 seconds. Are you ready? Go. All right, there's one. Oh, didn't get that one. Come on, huh? Ooh. Oh, better hit the schmoo itself. Throw kind of down at him. That's the idea. That's, you got the idea. There's two. Now, come on, get these other two off. There's three. One more is all you need. Come on, now. That's a girl. Good for you. You kind of like you played basketball in college, did you?
Yes, she did.
You did. You played basketball. I thought the way you handled that thing, you knew what you were doing. Basketball's a little smaller than that, I will admit. But the bonus! John, you get a chance to try the bonus stunt, two of you together. And I want to tell you now, it's worth $500 in cash. Each week it increases by $100 till somebody does it. Now, you both got to be kind of cooperative about this. Step out here with me, and girls, bring out the bonus stunt, if you will, please. There, it's a comparatively simple but evil-looking device. Thank you very much, and thank you, Betty. All right, will you step over here with me? Now, Miss Jakes, I want you to stand just about facing like I am, right here, see?
Okay.
Just facing right about out that way. That's good. Now, will you take this fishing pole? Always hold it by the handle in two hands. That's the idea. You notice suspended from the end of it is a normal little saucer. Now, you, sir, are to stand on this side of your wife and take this little implement that I have, which has a nice flat top to it, and what you do is manipulate holding this only in one hand and not touching it with your other hand at any time, with this under the bottom of the saucer, wind up with the saucer sitting on top of that little thing just like that. Do that, and it's worth $500 to you. Okay, boy? There you are. Take it in your hand. Take a look at the clock. See how many seconds you have. 45 seconds, as always. Are you ready? Go. Best bet is just hold still as you can, Miss Jakes. Just hold it as steady as you can. Mm-hmm. 20 seconds left yet. Mm-hmm. Almost had it, boy. Let it throw you now. Take it easy. Oh, golly, I'm sorry, boy. You didn't beat the clock. The clock beat you, but a good try. I thought you had it there once. That means it's worth another $100 next week. Good try. I Now, you understand, of course, that that was strictly in the nature of a bonus. The fact of not doing that still doesn't rob you at all. You go right along and try for your $200 clock, which you're going to do right quick like a bunny. So, as I say, that was a bonus. It's worth another $100 next week. That'll be $600 whenever the bell rings next week. So if you're watching, you'll see whether or not the guy gets it next time. You know just how nervous he is. Now, let's see. John and your wife's name is...
Rachel?
Can I call you Rachel?
Sure.
Okay, Johnny and Rachel, this time again, we have cooperation, just as the bonus was. The two of you will have to work this one out together, so will you come over here with me? This is for the $200 clock. Rachel, I'll ask you to take these two ends of string, if you will, from Madeline. John, suppose you take these two from Betty. That's it. Now, I want you to hold each string right by the end and then wrap it just once around your hand, any way you normally would. That's each of you do the same thing, just once around. Now, hold it good and tight, will you? Because we have a little platform here in the middle. If you hold it good and tight, then I can set this cup and saucer on it. See? I don't let it drop. That's the idea. Now, when I say go, your problem is this. Continuing to wrap these cords around your hands, work your way toward each other until you can remove the cup and you remove the saucer. When you've got the cup and you've got the saucer and haven't broken it, we'll stop the clock, you beat the clock. Now, should that cup and saucer fall off, we'll replace it, we'll stop the clock while we do, and you have to unwind all the way to the ends again where you are now. So don't waste time. Are you ready? Take a look at the clock. See how many seconds you have. 45. Go. We got another one. Come on. Unwind to the first position here. Hold it good and tight now. Good and tight. Good and tight. You ready? Go. Take it easy. That's the idea. You got the idea. Got the idea. Take it easy. Don't spend your wealth before you have it. Good and tight. Keep those strings wide, just like you have them. Still got 20 whole seconds, so don't rush yourself. Lose that when you're so close to the edge there. That's the idea. You take the cup, she takes the saucer. Get your thumb over there. That's a boy. All right, stop the clock! We're putting through the mill here. Oh, I guess you'd rather be home right, wouldn't you, huh? Maybe this will give you an idea. We may see ourselves in some fiction here before too much longer. Well, now, Johnny, you can't help your wife in this one at all. This is where the wife takes over, and Rachel, you've got to try our jackpot clock. Now, if you'll step right down there, I'll tell you when to get up on the platform. And back of this curtain, as I've explained before, is our magnetic jackpot board with all the words of a famous saying or quotation held there by magnetism, but they're all out of order. You got to move them around on that board until they spell out, reading from left to right, the saying or quotation we're after in 20 seconds from the time I say go. Do you understand? Okay, open the curtain. Step up on the platform. Go. Stop the clock. One man's meat is another man's fault. Give it to her, boy. That's the idea. And now let's take a look and see what you've won. Just take a look over here.
Mr. and Mrs. Jakes, your prize is the Sylvania Jefferson with 20-inch screen and Sylvania's exclusive halo light surround lighting for viewing comfort. This handsome set incorporates all of Sylvania's outstanding features, such as the exclusive triple lock tuning for perfect reception. The cabinet of the Jefferson is of rich mahogany finish and contains a powerful Sylvania chassis, which will bring you truly movie-clear television and studio-clear sound. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Jakes. You have just won Sylvania's jackpot prize.
Good idea. Best of good luck. Keep on writing, Johnny.
Okay, I will.
Hope I'm reading it soon.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Roxanne, who are our next contestants?
Mr. and Mrs. Albert Weinstein from Brooklyn, New York.
Well, thank you very much. Mr. and Mrs. Albert Weinstein or Weinstein?
Weinstein.
Weinstein. What do you do, Al?
A manufacturer.
If, over there in Brooklyn, what sort of things do you manufacture?
Little children's snowsuits and legging sets.
Oh, do you? Hey, your season's just about coming up, isn't it?
Oh, it's been on since March.
Oh, really? They order that far ahead?
Oh, yes.
How long married, Mrs. Weinstein?
14 years.
What about children?
Two daughters.
Two daughters. Well, I had two daughters first, then I had a son, so don't give up.
I thought you had three.
No, I have two daughters and then a son. Don't rush me here. That means that our time is all up, Mr. and Mrs. Weinstein of Brooklyn, New York. Now, you're not too far away. Can you come back next week?
Yes.
See? See what nerves we have on the show? Now you get an idea what was lined up for you for next time. Something with balloons.
All right.
Scared the dickens out of our girls.
She wants the pies.
Well, we'll see you next week, and we'll find out what it is at that time. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Bud Collyer speaking for Sylvania, hoping that next time may be your time to beat the clock. Good night, everybody.
Production, produced in association with the CBS Television Network. Roxanne Gone and Larry Ulrich original.